Ah yes, Duke Nukem. It's been a long time since his last game. He has a start in the 90s since the first 2D game, and Duke Nukem was everywhere in that decade with various games left and right. But the mid-2000s felt empty for Duke right after Duke Nukem Advanced and Manhattan Project. But then came long-awaited Duke Nukem Forever in 2011, which really wasn't the best return of Duke Nukem, along with the Nintendo DS game Duke Nukem Critical Mass. But after that, there is just nothing of the franchise outside of Duke Nukem 3D ports and Duke Nukem in Bulletstorm. I gotta be honest, it's boring without a new Duke Nukem game by 3D Realms and Gearbox. Thanks, Randy Pitchford. But anyway, the next year is the 30th anniversary of Duke Nukem, and I do feel about reviewing an old game like the one that is on the video title of my video, Duke Nukem 3D, which of course is Duke Nukem 3. Now let's see how well this game holds up since 1996, along with its port and even the 20th anniversary World Tour version added to the mix of my review, and let's rock and roll, and it's time to kick ass and chew bubblegum. And I'm all out of gum. Now Duke Nukem 3D doesn't waste time on stories. It begins when Duke's rider, after the events of Duke Nukem 2, gets shot down by those alien bastards, and he's none too happy about it. Which leads Duke to kick some alien ass in 5 episodes of LA Meltdown, Lunar Apocalypse, Shrapnel City, first appeared in the first game, The Birth, and Alien World Order, introduced in 20th Anniversary World Tour. There are in total between 6 to 11 levels per episodes. The combat in this game is fast, just like how it was popularized by Doom. Duke carries weapons like pistol, shotgun, RPG, chain gun, and incinerator, the flamethrower from World Order, but there are other weapons other than standard FPS weapons like remote detonated pipe bomb, shrink ray, and microwave expander that shrinks the enemy and oversizes the enemy, rapid fire rocket launcher devastator, laser trip bomb, and freeze thrower. He also has portable items like holoduke, jetpack, night vision goggles, portable medkit, protectable boots for something hazardous, scuba gear, and steroids that doubles Duke's speed and attack power. There are enemies like assault trooper with jetpack along with teleporting jerk versions, chain gun wielding hit scanning enforcers, shotgunning Pika with satisfying death squeal along with their recon patrol vehicle and tank, facehugging protozoid slimer, octobrain, protector drone, assault commander, which I still call BS on my bro and dad that I was scared of them as a kid, and finally world tour exclusive firefly trooper. Each episode ends with, what else, a boss fight with Battlelord, which is this one that I was scared as a kid because of the roar along with its minor version, and also the roar was brought back in Metroid Zero Mission for Kraid, twin rocket launcher wielding Overlord, Cyclode Emperor, Alien Queen, and World Tour exclusive Cyclode Incinerator, which is yawn-worthy boss. The levels aren't just finding some alien pissants, but also finding ammo for your guns, restoring your health and armor, and collecting colored key card for each door because, well, as Duke said in Forever, he doesn't need an effing key card. Yeah, sorry I brought it up, but collecting key card are nowhere near as fun as finding secrets throughout the level, which are fun, and the levels are both complex and even sprawling. I love getting the RPG, chain gun, and pipe bombs on the first level of the first episode with jetpack, and I love the level variety. Now there is online multiplayer on co-op campaign and deathmatch, but I could not find any matches because I only own the Megaton edition, so there is that. I can't say anything about the multiplayer on my end though. And also, you can make your own custom levels, which is not my cup of tea, but it's there if you like making levels. Now do I think in terms of gameplay, Duke 3D hold up well by today's standards? Well, I think it does for the most part, except those key card hunting. I did enjoy how timeless Duke 3D feels, which we will segue to the next segment of the review.
I'm getting too old for this shit.
Before the invention of Unreal Engine, Duke Nukem 3D uses Ken Silverman's build engine. The environments are displayed in 3D, but the enemies, women, and Duke himself are displayed in 2D. Duke and the bosses are also rendered in 3D cutscenes. While it is an old-looking 3D engine, the engine does have its charms, like leaving bullet holes and blood splatter in the wall, opening lifelike doors, which isn't that new in FPSs, select the light switches, and even destructible environments like glasses, electronics, and even walls, ceilings, and floors. The attention to detail is impressive, especially when you spot pop culture references to the TV shows like Simpsons, movies like Terminator, and video games like Doom. I also need to mention that the Saturn version uses Lobotomy Software's Slave Driver engine introduced in the console version of Power Slave. The level variety is amazing, from movie theaters, bars, strip clubs, space stations, alien hives, prisons, restaurants, and other type of levels, which is a long one to list them all. Also, the voice acting for Duke Nukem is classic yet good, thanks to John St. John, who would continue voicing Duke. Now, the redone voices of Duke in the 20th anniversary world tour sounds, in my opinion, jarring, but the new line sounds okay though. But other music sounds great too, like The Stalker, The City Streets, Sneaky Snake, Future Military Conquest, Aliens Say Your Prayers, In Hiding, Missing Impossible, Pissed Office Box, and last but not least, Departure. Now, Doom series has my favorite soundtrack on any first-person shooters, but Duke 3D's soundtrack is still good. Duke Nukem 3D visuals might not look that impressive by today's standards, but it still have its charm, and heck, the Ion Fury looks advanced by today's standards if it wasn't for Duke 3D, and the game has a good soundtrack to Duke's Boot. No pun intended. Duke Nukem 3D, man, I love this classic game that is still fun to play. The combat is fast-paced, and the way I like it in FPS games without reloading my weapons, except when Duke reloads his pistol, and even interacting with the environment. Back in the day, it was an evolution on FPS with its interaction on the environment thanks to the build engine first used in Witch Haven, which is later used in future games outside of Duke 3D, like 3D Realm's own Shadow Warrior, Power Slave, Blood, and even Ion Fury. If I rate this game, I would give this game a 9 out of 10. If you have never played Duke 3D back in the 90s, then what are you waiting for? Christmas? You can find Duke Nukem 3D on PC as physical copy, and even digital as 20th Anniversary World Tour, because the GOG version and Megaton Edition are no longer on Steam. Hell, the Megaton Edition is also removed on PS3 and PS Vita PlayStation Store as well. Thanks, Gearbox. And you can find console versions of Duke 3D like the Saturn version, PS1 version called Total Meltdown with remixed and original music, along with its own 4th episode Plug and Pray, N64 version, Xbox 360 version, and the previously mentioned 20th Anniversary World Tour Edition, also on PS4 and Xbox One. Nerve Software and Gearbox, I'm still winning the Switch version of 20th Anniversary World Tour so the Nintendo fans don't have to play the uncensored N64 version. Oh, and stay away from the Gamecom version, it's by far the worst version of Duke Nukem 3D. I would really like to see Duke Nukem 5 being made and taking lessons from Doom 2016 and Doom Eternal. Gearbox and 3D Realms, make it happen. Oh, and keep Randy Pitchford out from ruining it and make it happen for the fans. I'm the Electric Izanagi, and I have something to say about crappy lists of Watch Mojo, and it's the same way as Duke says at the end of Duke Nukem Forever.
What kind of shit ending is that?